it was just above a chilly 0 degrees when we travelled into the foothills of the Southern Alps. There, a small order of monks live a life of poverty and sacrifice, a simple, structured, yet demanding existence. Once rejected by the Catholic Church, this ultra-traditional order of monks is growing. Tonight, Miriam Akamo gets to know the Transalpine Redemptorists. And again, we filmed the story before lockdown restrictions.
It's a magnificent yet unforgiving environment.
I don't long for anything because I have what I want.
Where this tiny community...
A longing that I do have is for others to know what I know and feel what I feel.
Live a life of hard work, service and sacrifice.
How old are you?
19, yes.
Ooh.
That wind is quite chilly, isn't it?
It is freezing. This is the life you chose.
Each day starts exactly the same.
We get up at 5 to 5 and we have half an hour to get ready, and then we spend an hour and a half in private prayer.
For Father Anthony Mary, Brother Raphael, Brother Paul, and new entrant Brother Charles Marie.
It's very structured.
Yeah, it is. That's one of the things I really like about this life.
Come on.
We have a period of work for a few hours before the midday meal.
They do everything themselves here. Hands on, robes on, all working purposefully towards a greater goal.
God gives suffering for your own good.
So that's why you work hard every day outside?
Yeah, that is part of it, yeah.
In whatever weather?
Yeah, because the idea of work is to weaken the body so that you have greater control over it, really. Mm-hmm.
It's pretty cold here.
It can get quite cold, like we've got a fire, a wood burner. You've had temperature -8 in the morning. It's not that cold.
Oh, my gosh. Do you seek out challenging environments?
Not at all, no. It seems to be God places us in them.
4 years ago, the Transalpine Redemptorists bought this property, Mount St. Joseph, in the South Canterbury foothills. It's one of three monasteries they own around the world, all of them remote and all of them off the grid.
By taking on a challenging climate or challenging situation, it's a demonstration of our love that we do it for the love of God. We don't have television, we don't have radio, don't bring in the newspapers. We do have the internet to use for emails. It seems it's the modern way of communicating.
What will thou kill me?
Half of our life is secluded, and the other half is apostolic, going out and preaching. So the week that we're here, we kind of fill ourselves with God.
And that's why you are also remote?
Yes, yeah. It's very peaceful here, you know.
But key to that peace is obedience. Challenging for a young monk.
What was the hardest thing to let go of?
Probably the fact that I can't do anything at the time that I want, what I want, basically. Yeah, so I always have to obey. It's another of the vows, a vow of obedience.
So we're going to go and have a look at your room.
Mm-hmm.
After you. Oh, my Lord. Freezing hands. Oh, gosh. Am I allowed to say that? Oh, my Lord.
I wouldn't, personally.
No, you wouldn't.
I don't think so.
No, okay. I'll try not to as well.
Yeah.
Newly minted monk, Brother Charles Marie, is just 19. So young to give up so much.
So this is my cell.
Ah. Oh, wow. Okay, so very spare. So you have a bed, yep, and a desk, sure, and somewhere to put your clothes.
Yep, that's about it.
And that's about it.
Well, I'm part of religious poverty, so you can't own too many like superfluous things.
Right, yeah.
And to be as poor as possible.
To be as poor as possible.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Really, yeah.
at some point you will own literally nothing, mm-hmm. even your own socks.
Mm-hmm. That's right, yeah. And they can, so I'll be given things for my own use, but they can be taken from me at any moment.
Mm-hmm. So you are literally just Brother Charles Marie. Mm-hmm. That is all you own is your name.
Yeah, and even that can be taken from me.
Wow.
In an age of consumption, it seems extraordinary. But it's what Brother Charles agreed to when he became a novice.
It's very exciting, inwardly, yeah. Yeah, there were many, many blessings which I received that day. Yeah, I came with Benedict, which is the name I was baptised with, and Brother Charles Marie de Jesus.
It is a very courageous thing to do in this day and age.
Parents Daniel and Schumann.
When he told us that he was going to try it out, I was in tears. But as parents, nothing makes us happier than having him consecrate his life to God.
May the Lord strip thee of the old man together.
The idea is to let go of worldly desires or stripping away of the old man.
So getting rid of that old man and putting on the new is, you know, is embracing this life of sacrifice, of difficulty, and not succumbing to the desires that are fundamental to my nature.
Brother Charles is the eldest of six homeschooled children. He left home to enter the order.
We're a pretty close family, so it was difficult even then as well for me. But because I'm going to something better, more perfect, I think we're all very happy.
We are a really tight-knit family. So to lose him was painful.
It's sacrifice all round.
Did you consider that this would mean you wouldn't be able to get married one day or have children?
Yeah, definitely.
Has there ever been a moment where you thought it would have been nice to have had my own family?
No, and I don't desire to have children now or don't miss it in any way. The faith that come to the Mass are like children. Why do I sacrifice myself? Why do I not get married? And why do I not enjoy the pleasures that are available? Well, it's a sacrifice that I make to testify my love for God.
But to understand just what that means for Brother Charles, look at this. A musical prodigy at just 5. He traveled the world, his life dedicated to music, until he entered the monastery.
Can you play music whenever you like?
Not whenever I like, because, well, I have to have permission for that.
He has permission today, but once he takes his full vows, the violin will be taken.
Do you think you'll feel a pang once it goes?
Yes, I think I will. But again, that's part of the sacrifice which you're giving to God, and any sacrifice, well, the more you can give, the happier you are.
But that doesn't mean it's easy.
That my mind is just occupied with it. And it doesn't seem to stop for a while afterwards, yeah. Mm-hmm.
What's it thinking after you play?
Well, just constantly throughout the day, I'm just thinking music thoughts. I don't know how to explain it, really.
So music is deep in your soul?
Yeah, I think it's definitely part of me and it's not going to go away, no matter how much I try.
So it really does speak to the size of the sacrifice?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You can say that, yeah, it does.
Father Anthony understands youthful sacrifice. He too was 19 when he entered the seminary.
What did your parents think?
They were delighted.
Of their 9 children, 4, including Father Anthony, entered religious life.
Did you have a sign? Was there a calling?
I don't think I've had any strong call in that way. Along the pathway, I did have a friendship with a girl. And so when I told her that, and I wanted to be a priest, And when we did break up, she said, well, maybe it's God's, you know, calling you to be the priest or follow your vocation. And if that was a moment when I did then follow my vocation. So I suppose in a certain sense, but it wasn't like a thunderbolt.
His was a traditionalist pathway. So when the church modernised in the 60s, rejecting the Latin Mass, Father Anthony and fellow priest Father Michael formed the Transalpine Redemptorists. He was just 22 when the Vatican cast them out.
What was it like to be separated from Rome?
Yes, we were treated with scorn often.
They operated outside of church law, continuing with the Latin Mass.
So you were breaking the law?
So strictly speaking, yes.
But 24 years later, Pope Benedict invited the traditionalists back into the fold. And the Latin Mass, it seems, is experiencing a global revival.
Yeah, we're growing. We're growing.
And as their congregation grows, so too do their dreams.
You're very handy, aren't you?
Well, actually, the next job I have to do is sew some a habit for the postman on Friday.
You're sewing a habit?
Yeah. So, like the one that Brother Charles and Marie is wearing, I sewed that last week. I sewed the one I'm wearing.
What can you not do? I think is probably the better question.
I can't play a violin. How's that?
As they look to build a new monastery.
But this is where the monastery will go.
Yeah, so being that this is kind of the highest spot that we have in our property.
High in the heavens.
Please God, over the years there'll be more who will come along and, you know, see the benefit of what we're doing and have a desire to give themselves to God.
Join the brothers.
Join the brothers.
The brothers' funding comes mainly from American benefactors, two of whom anonymously donated the $350,000 it cost to buy the Geraldine property. And young brother Charles Marie is set to leave in September to live at their monastery in the Orkney Islands, north of Scotland.